see so many people here tonight. Smashing. Nice to be back with you. I think this is the fourth time I've played for you. Twice at the Redcliffe and twice here as well. So, and a third different instrument for you tonight. I think my first two concerts I played at Yamaha HS8. The last time was Technics C800. This time it's the Wersi. So I hope you enjoy the sound of the Wersi. Tonight it's the Wega, which is very similar to the Spectra, if you know what a Spectra is. If you don't know what a Spectra is, you don't know what the hell I'm talking about. So, but yeah. Anyway, that was a piece of music called Triumphant Music. Might be a new one on you. Again, I'm going to try and put a few different things into the program for you, try and do something a little bit different. And I'm going to continue with something which is hopefully a little bit different. I normally try and put a selection of tunes from one of my favourite singers. I think the last time I played for you I did a selection of Nat King Cole tunes. This time it's a different gentleman. He's known as the Emperor of Easy. So does anybody know who it is? No. No. No, no. 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 It's funny, you know, I mean, he's a top singer and yet he very rarely gets a mention or people that bring his... No, he's not Tony Manning. No. I'll put you out of your misery. It's Mr. Andy Williams. Thank you. change, doesn't it? Oh, it makes a change from Frank Sinatra, which is what you normally get, I think, isn't it? But, that's the idea, you see. Try and give you something a little bit different. And again, this really applies to the next piece. It's Johann Strauss, but it's a piece that you might not have heard for a long time, or maybe not at all, I don't know. It's called The Treasure Waltz from the Gypsy Baron. In fact, you can just imagine them all dancing around you doing those fancy frocks and whatever, you can't you? Can just imagine it. Close your eyes, but don't fall asleep. Okay? Can I take my jacket off now?
Yeah.
I'll get warmer. Has it started already, has it? Oh dear. Have you had Tommy Stace here, by the way?
Yes.
Well, I'm in competition with him to see who can lose the most fluid on the stage. Oh no, that sounds terrible, doesn't it? Let's get on with the music. Completely. So I'm going to start that again. Take two. Cut. Cut. Thank you. That's one you don't hear too often as well, isn't it? Makes a change from the blue Danube, doesn't it? That's what we normally get, I think. Okay, right. Well, as I said earlier, this is the Wersi Wega, which is very similar to the Spectra, which is also the last instrument that dear old Klaus Wunderlich used to play. So with that in mind, also Klaus was probably the player that influenced me most while I was playing through the years. So what I thought I'd do is do a little medley of some Klaus tunes, because he wrote quite a few pieces of music. Normally, if you bought a record of his in the days when there were records, or a CD, normally you'll find on there somewhere there's a composition written by Klaus. And I've put some of my favourites together in a medley for you. We're going to start off with a march called Happy Beat. Then we've got a rumba by the name of Verziana. Then we've got a tango called Tango Italiano. Then a nice ballad called Strings of Paradise. A Japanese tune, would you believe, called Yokohama Melody. And then a sort of a piano swing tune to finish up with called Piano Charlie. So here's some of the music of Klaus Wunderlich on his organ. Well, not his organ exactly, but you know what I mean.
Oh,
you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, he wrote some good tunes, didn't he? Yeah, some good catchy tunes there. He wrote a lot more, of course, but those were just some of my favourites. Okay, right. Well, it's almost time for a cup of tea. But before we do that, I'm going to finish up, staying on the German theme, really. It's a little bit of Robert Stoltz to finish up the first half. Not only did he, of course, write the music for the White Horse Inn, but he also wrote some other tunes as well, and there's a couple of those which I've put in the selection I'm going to finish up the first half with. And, of course, I have got some tapes and CDs for sale. There's a new one since the last time I was here called Dance With Me. You don't have to dance with me to, you know, you just listen to it. There is, 55, I think. There's 55 tunes on there. 25 tracks, over 70 minutes running time. So you're getting value for money. That's on the CD. That's on the CD. On the tape, there are a couple of tracks that aren't on the tape version, but if you buy the CD, you've got, let's say, over 70 minutes running time. Anyway, enough of the commercials. Here's a little bit of Robert Stoltz. I hope you've enjoyed the first half, and I hope you'll enjoy the second half. Just one other thing. I finish up with goodbye. Don't panic. Don't panic, I'm coming back. Well, if you want me to come back, that is.
Thank you.
the second half. Thank you.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I think we've had a very good first half, and I know the second will be equally as good. We go and have our cup of tea now and back for the draw. Thank you.
There you go, a little bit of Latin American music. Always goes down well, doesn't it?
Yeah?
I don't know why, but, well, they're good tunes, I suppose. Good tunes, aren't they? Okay, right. Well, after all that, you can put your maracas away now, by the way. After all that excitement, let's have something a little quieter and a bit more relaxed, shall we? It's amazing when you think about it, how many tunes have got the word dream or dreaming or dreams in the title. So I thought I'd put together a little dreamy medley for you now. There's two new ones and two old ones for you here. Starting off with the old tune, I Can Dream, Can't I? Then one of a newer tune called Dream Theme. Then we go back in time again for another oldie called Put Your Dreams Away. And then finishing up with House of Dreams. So a nice dreamy medley for you, but I don't want anybody falling asleep, okay? very much. Thank you. Are you all still awake? You're still awake? Good. Okay. I haven't mentioned this little gadget that I've got over here. I did use it the last time I was here when I played with Technics. It's a Korg I5M expander. Basically, it gives me extra sounds and extra rhythms. But I would say 90% of what you're hearing tonight is coming from the organ. There's just a couple of little extra things that I bring in there that, would you believe, isn't on the Wersi. So that's that little gadget over there explained. Okay, right. Well, again, this next selection, I suppose, is hopefully a little bit different. I enjoy watching a good war film. I don't suppose everybody does enjoy watching a good war film, but hopefully you'll all agree that there has been some good music written for war movies. So I've put together a little medley here. We've got things like The Longest Day, As Time Goes By, Great Escape, The Winds of War. Do you remember The Winds of War? Yeah, it went on week after week after week. Everybody was waiting for Robert Mitchum to start acting, if you remember. Yeah, you remember that one, don't you? And I think they followed it up with War and Remembrance, didn't they? And you finally got to the end of Winds of War, they came up with a sequel. Anyway, I used to watch it as well, isn't me? I'm complaining about it. But it's a nice theme. You'll probably recognise it when you hear it. The one after that is going to definitely, it'll be almost definitely a new one on you. It's from the film Is Paris Burning? It's a nice musette, French accordion piece. It's written by Maurice Jarre, who wrote a lot of music like Dr. Zhivago and tunes like that. Then we got From Here to Eternity, 633 Squadron. And then I'm going to finish up with a piece which isn't from a film, but it's a wartime tune that it seems appropriate to finish up with. And normally the crowd burst out singing at the end, because they all know it, they sing their heads off. No pressure though, no pressure. Now you'll all know it, in fact you'll probably guess what it's going to be. But anyway, here we go. Thank you. Thank you. Well done, the singers. Well done, the singers. Okay. You didn't let me down. You didn't let me. I knew you wouldn't let me down. Okay, right. Well, doesn't time fly when you're having fun? Hey?
Yes.
Have you enjoyed it?
Yes.
Yes? Do you like the sound of the organ? Yeah? Good? Good? Okay. Right, well, it's time for the last medley, unfortunately. Before I go into the last medley, I'm going to take the jacket off. Now, I haven't really played any show music for you tonight, so I'm going to finish up with a selection of a couple of gentlemen who I think wrote some of the best show music long before this young upstart Andrew Lloyd Webber came on the scene. Mr. Rodgers and Hammerstein, and you've got tunes here from Oklahoma, King and I, Carousel, Sound of Music, Flower Drum Song, and what's the other one? Oh, South Pacific, yeah, I mustn't forget South Pacific. Okay, so once again, ladies and gentlemen, it's been fantastic to see so many people here tonight, and I hope I can play for you on a fifth occasion. Yes, please? Until then, thank you very much. Good night. Thank you.
clap loud enough, we might get a bit more.
I can't get out that way, there's no escape. Well, it just so happens that, you know, just in case of emergencies, you know. Oh, I've got one more for you. Of course I have. I'm going to let you try and work this last piece out, what I'm going to play. All I'm going to say is that I hope you don't see any strings while I'm playing this piece of music. Okay, I have painted them out against the background, but you just might occasionally see the odd string. What the hell is he talking about? Good night, thank you.
Nicholas Martin on the 2nd of October.